Alright, welcome to another video, and before we get started, I'd like to take a quick minute to thank all the Patreon supporters and YouTube channel members whose names you see scrolling across the screen right now. They make this financially possible, and without you, I probably wouldn't be here making videos, so thank you. Alright, so as you can see, today we have something a little bit different on the workbench here. This large foam case arrived in the mail, and you might remember I posted on the community tab about this. It's a new plane, the Firefly, from Haohan. I guess that's how you pronounce it. I hope I'm not butchering their name too bad. They sent me this little aluminum tag, this little etch tag. I kind of stuck it on here. There's the brand name there. You can kind of see this is number 000. I guess one of the first few off the line. Pre-production sample. But that's their name. I'll have a link to their website and everything below. There was a Kickstarter campaign running for this. I'm not sure if it's still going to be available or not by the time this video is out. It's pretty close to the end. But either way, I'll have a link to their website where you can find out more information, and I do believe these should be available on Banggood at some point in the future. But for now, we're just going to kind of take a look at what they sent me. Like I said, you have this nice big foam case, and I realize it's kind of difficult to get it all in the shot. If I step back here, you can kind of see it. There's my transmitter over there and a bunch of other junk back here in the background, and some chargers and batteries and more stuff back there, just kind of give you a size reference. But anyway, like I said, you do have this kind of nice, quality, robust carrying handle here on the case. And these little latches, we'll open those up. There's one and the other. And we'll sit this down so that it doesn't fall open. And once again, you see the branding there in the top. And you open this up, and it's kind of a little plastic hinge back here. And you see the airplane itself fits nicely inside. I'll just kind of pull some of these parts out and sit them aside for now. Let's go ahead and pull one wing half at a time. We'll sit that in the chair here. We'll get the other one out. And it kind of gives you a look at what's inside below the wings, because they kind of do sit on top of everything. Here's the fuselage. You can see the tail down there. There's an extra nose piece here. There's a bag of extra parts here. This is like battery strap and some camera mounting accessories and things like that. And in this little case here is a flight controller. The flight controller is optional. You can get a plug-and-play or the plug-and-play plus flight controller and GPS, which is basically what I have. And then there's another version that comes with a camera and maybe a gimbal. I'm not really sure. But that's all going to be laid out on their website. But like I said, I guess you get all the nose pieces with the different versions of it. I'm not real sure because this, like I said, this is a pre-production sample that they sent me to kind of check out and fly and review and kind of promote it and show it off. But this nose piece here, you can see it's set up for a fixed FPV camera mount. And there's some empty space up in the top there with some little rails that you can slide flat plates into for different, you know, mounting different like video transmitters and things. And that kind of opens the door for 3D printing some accessories. So I'm sure we'll see some of those come out, because I'll probably be making one for myself at least, if nothing else. And the fuselage here, this has a different nose piece that's basically just kind of hollow. I think it's the same plastic molded piece as that. It just doesn't have the foam insert. So if you want it to hang, like I said, the version with the camera gimbal, I'm guessing the flat plate just kind of hangs in, you know, slides in there, and the gimbal hangs out under it where it has a view to look around from the front there. But you can kind of see the design of it, where the wings are going to attach up here on the top, and then you have the payload bay, which is where your flight controller and battery and camera FPV gear and everything is down here. Then your tail is going to run out from back here up high, and you just have this kind of bay hanging down here. And this carbon propeller is included. It's Haohan brand. It's branded with their brand name and everything. It wasn't installed. It came with in a little separate baggie. And I went ahead and installed it myself. I did need to work on this a little bit. It didn't run straight and true out of the box. I had to file the hub a little bit and do some sanding on the heavy blade to balance it. But I got it running nice and smooth, so I just left it mounted for now. So like I said, this is kind of pretty much an unboxing, but I've already unboxed it and kind of took a look at everything and went over it good and then kind of repackaged it to kind of show you. So I did want to point that out. A lot of these accessories, like the spare nose and the flight controller and some of this other stuff, it was all packaged neatly inside here. better than I have it now. I just kind of threw things back in the box just to kind of take them back out and show you for this video. But we'll set the fuselage here where we can take a look inside. So you have this nice little latch. Kind of unclip it, and the top just kind of tabs in there. And I kind of like that. It's better than magnets. It doesn't mess with the compass if you have one. Well, the GPS goes up in the top anyway. Kind of up here in top of the wing, you see that little cover there. You take two screws out, and that's a little pocket for the GPS. But, I mean, it's a little bit more secure than magnets are anyway. So there's no harm, no foul for going that route, I think. And in here, you can see this is a Velcro strap that's pre-installed with some Velcro strips down on the floor there where your battery can fit. And you do have a little hole right there that opens into the front compartment. If we look in there, you can kind of see that hole. And there's another hole you might have saw. You can kind of see light coming through there when we hold it up and look at it from the front. And bear with me, because like I said, I am trying to film all this on my phone and it's a little bit awkward. But yeah, you can see that opening in the top. That opens up into here, and there is a little 3D printed piece that they included in that bag of spare parts that looks like it's intended to kind of glue it down onto the top here, and has a little FPV camera mount to mount, like the little normal 4mm camera, antenna, not camera, FPV antenna mount to hold the little stem type antenna, so it'll sit back here behind the prop. So like I said, the way this is situated, the prop is up above the nose, and you kind of get the benefits of a tractor style setup with the prop on the nose without, you know, the prop interfering with your view from your camera, because your camera is going to hang down here below it. So it's kind of the best of both worlds. It should be quiet and efficient as any other single prop tractor would be, but you still get the unobstructed view from the front there. And you might notice these little air vents right here. These are molded plastic glued into the foam. And there's another one you can see kind of the light coming in over on the other side. And if we take a look on this side of the fuselage, there's no hatch on this side. It's just a solid foam piece. But that little vent is molded in just like the one on this side. And that lets air in to this compartment. And I guess, yeah, there's an air exit back here. There's another foam piece, kind of molded foam piece back here, to let the air leave, and that will keep your flight controller and things cool, because your flight controller does go under this little hatch in the back here, which we'll take a look at that in a minute. And I guess maybe cool your battery, because you are going to get a little bit of air through the front there. Not a whole lot, but some air will come through. But typically you don't need to really cool your battery that much anyway. Now I've not seen the speed controller in here, so when you take this bay off this little cover, it's just a little pocket right here where the GPS is the only thing in here. There's no speed controller under this, but the motor, the way it's mounted on this carbon tube, and it's a relatively large diameter carbon tube, and the speed controller wires, you can see the signal lead and the battery leads go up into the top there and out to the motor. So my guess is the speed controller is riding inside this carbon tube here, so I'm not really sure where it gets cooling air, or if it needs cooling air. I don't even know the specs on the speed controller. And you see, you do have this nice little injection molded motor mount here that even has a little pocket to hide the wires and keep them protected. And while we're talking about the motor, it is a Haohan branded 2216 1100 kV motor, as you can see there. And like I said, that carbon tube just kind of runs back into this little top pod. And I guess it's probably extended into there. And speaking of this rear hollow piece here, you might notice there's some little connectors down in there, some little contacts, and that's for the front of this tail boom, which is another carbon rod. And you see that piece just kind of plugs into it. We'll take a look at this in a minute. We'll pull it out. When you plug that in, that makes the connection inside here for your rudder and elevator servos, which is what some of these leads down here are. You see, we have a nice little selection of different leads. You have four servo wires, that's with two ailerons, the rudder and elevator. Then you have a few more of these little LED wires. There are LEDs in the wingtips as well. We'll take a look at that in just a bit. So we're going to go ahead and set the fuselage. Actually, we're not going to set the fuselage aside just yet. Bear with me. I'm going to unscrew this. You see there's a little thumb screw in this that holds this back hatch on. I'm going to unscrew that here. I'll be right back once I get that off, because it's probably going to take two hands. All right, as you can see now, we've got that screw back out. It's just a little nylon M3 thumb screw. And there's a tab on the front of the hatch and tab on each side just to kind of keep it located in place. And that does fit onto the rear section of the fuselage that we can see here. And this little bay right here, you see you have four mounting holes in this wood plate. This wood plate does come out. It's just kind of slid in place right now. It kind of slides in these rails, much like the pieces do in the nose that I showed you. But these four mounting holes are where the flight controller screws down to, or you can mount it onto the flat wood plate with some double-sided tape if you prefer to do that. And you see back here you have this other little PCB right here with a power input lead that you plug into the servo rail, so it takes 5 volts in. And then there's a little button here, and your LEDs plug into it, and it's basically your LED controller. It makes the lights flash and strobe in different patterns, or I forget. They did send me a manual for it. I kind of looked through it, but I forget some of the details. But I know there's at least two different patterns. I think it was two different patterns that you can do with the LEDs. But basically, you see one of your leads comes from the back here. That's an LED in this little clear dome, kind of a little magnifier lens you can see there. I believe this is a white LED, and then your wingtips, you have red and green LEDs into the wingtips. And like I said, you see one of your leads here that just kind of goes back up, and when you plug your wings in, it makes a connection right here. The wings just kind of snap in and they latch on here, which I'll show you in just a bit. But so that's pretty much everything in the fuselage, in and around it. So let me set the fuselage aside and we will take a look at the tail pieces. So the main part, you have this tail boom with your elevator, and the servos go on top. You see your elevator servo and the rudder servo. I like the way they're embedded into the foam like that. There's basically just barely a little bump in the foam around the servo. It's really a nice clean way to do it. And they kind of do like the Zod Altus ailerons do. There's, or the V-tail actually. The ailerons on the Altus have a linkage, but the V-tail is set up like this. You see the horns for the servos, they just kind of key into these molded plastic pieces, which attach to your control surfaces, and it just kind of direct drives them off of the servo arm. And in fact, you see the rudder one, the servo arm is there, and it's just exposed until you install the rudder, which has a pocket in the bottom of the rudder right there that sits on top of that servo arm. So you see, once you plug the servo in, that little pocket just kind of captures the servo arm, and the rudder works, the servo works the rudder. And as far as installing the rudder, see you have this little carbon tab right down here, and these two little foam lugs. Those lugs fit into these holes. The tab keys into here, and you have a thumb screw here, which you would unscrew and plug this in and snug that screw up. And that's another thing I needed to address, this little carbon plate in the bottom of the rudder, which is what kind of attaches it to the rest of the tail. This little plate, the glue seemed to not be holding, or if it was glued at all, it wasn't glued very good. And when I would put this, when I installed it, I was able to wiggle the rudder around enough that the vertical fin was able to wiggle around enough on this plate, because the plate was tightened down into the tail, but the fin was loose on the plate, and I could easily get the rudder to to disengage off of the servo. So I kind of pushed this little plate back in where it went and wicked some thin CA down here and hit it with some kicker, and it took care of that issue. But keep in mind these little issues that I'm kind of pointing out. I'm just doing it for transparency, because I mean, this is what they sent me and this is the issues that I've had, and they are minor issues, but they are relevant. And but like I said, do keep in mind that this is a pre-production sample, and they've assured me that they are tweaking things as far as the foam molds and everything, and kind of their manufacturing process. They're addressing the little issues. They kind of told me about them before the plane even arrived, and I kind of knew what to expect. But I do believe that once these go on sale and they're doing mass production, that they probably will have addressed these issues. At least that's the plan. But like I said, for transparency, this is what I got, and I'm just kind of explaining to you that even in that case, they're not a big deal. None of it's a showstopper anyway, as long as you properly address them. But anyway, like I said, this little piece here on the front of this carbon rod, you see there's little slots, if I can get it to sit in place. See there's little slots, little grooves that kind of key this into the main part of the fuselage. If I can get it to focus here, come on, focus, focus. And you see there's little spring-loaded contacts right in there. If you push on them, they're springy. And when you plug this in and secure it with this nut, this little threaded nut kind of slides up this collar. It slides up the boom and tightens down onto there and threads, like I said, onto the back of the fuselage there. And all these contacts in here, the six pins, make contact with the connector inside the back of the fuselage. And that is the two servo leads for the elevator and rudder servos. So you basically screw that in and plug the rudder on and snap the wings in and you're good to go. So we're actually going to move this because that's everything that's in the case. And like I said, it's a little bit cumbersome with the big case on here. So I'm going to move some of this out of the way. And then we're going to take a look at the wings. So I'll be right back. Bear with me. All right, so we moved that phone case out of the way. And now we have the wing half sitting on the desk here. And like I said, you can see the servos in here. That's actually the servo arm coming out here, and it keys into this plastic piece just like the tail did. And if we take a look at the underside, you can see it better. You can kind of see this little plastic piece here is molded so that it sits around the servo arm and it's directly driven off of the servo. And again, they did an excellent job molding those servos cleanly into the foam there so that it's really smooth and aerodynamic and there's no extra drag or anything involved with it. And as long as you don't run into an issue with the control throw, which you can adjust all your endpoints and everything anyway, even if you're flying manually without a flight controller, you can do it, or you can do it in your flight controller too. But as long as it's not too far off and you end up giving up too much resolution or anything like that with the servos, then it should be fine. But I do know that they've done extensive flight testing on this, and there's videos of it on their channel, which I'll link to below this video as well. And you can go check out some of their testing videos. They've tested a lot of flight characteristics and aerodynamics and thing, and it seems to be a pretty refined design. But while it's upside down here, you can see this is one of the wingtip LEDs. They're kind of on the bottom side of the wings there. It's kind of turned out on an angle a bit. And the top is just clean. There's nothing going on up here. At the wing root there, you have the two carbon spars. If my camera will focus, try to get it to focus here. We have the two carbon spars and the contacts that make a connection to the fuselage when you plug the wings in. And this kind of molded plastic piece here that keeps everything lined up. And they have these nice little latches too that catch onto the little tabs that I showed you on the fuselage. These are little spring-loaded latches. Makes for a really quick and easy way to unlatch the wing and pull it off, but it's a really positive catch when you do plug them in. And the other wing is just exactly the same, just mirror it to the opposite side, obviously. Here's your wingtip LED and the servo. And you have the same catch up here on the top. Same two carbon spars and the connector in the wing root. So what I'll do now, I'm going to sit the camera aside and I'm going to actually plug everything in and show you the airplane assembled. And we'll close the video out from there, so I'll be right back. Alright, so now we're back, and as you can see, we have the airplane assembled on the bench there, and it actually makes a pretty sizable little plane. But it's a nice, clean layout, nice, clean look and design. I think it should be fairly efficient, relatively efficient, the way it's got this single tractor prop up here. And given the prop design and low KV of the motor and everything, it should be a pretty efficient setup. And you have this nice little payload bay down here that carries your electronics and your camera and everything. And the tail is nice and up out of the way. And should make pretty pretty neutral flight characteristics and everything. Other than the weight hanging down below, it's probably got a little bit of inherent stability. Kind of a pendulum effect from that. But I guess we'll see once we get it in the air and fly it. I don't want to kind of judge a book by its cover, because it's not always accurate. But anyway, pretty interested in this one, pretty excited to get it set up and flying. Still waiting on a little bit more info. Like I said, I just barely got this in the mail and doing an unboxing on it right now. The flight controller that they sent is an F405, and in fact, bear with me, I'm going to open this up and lay it out and kind of show it to you while I talk about it. All right, as you can see, I've kind of unlatched all. There's four latches around this little case that you kind of have to open up. And it comes in actually a nice little padded plastic case. But you can see this is the flight controller itself. This is one of their flight controllers. It's an F405. Plane and copter, INAV, and Ardu pilot targets. Which, that's kind of where I'm at right now. I'm kind of waiting for some more information. This did ship with Ardu pilot 4.4.0 on it. And when you plug it into Mission Planner, it identifies as a Matec F405TE target. So I'm not 100% sure if that's the stock firmware or if it's modified at all. It's kind of what I'm waiting on right now before I update it and mess something up. And I would kind of interested in the INAV target as well. But basically, you see you have your power input back here. And I guess that little holes right here, which I've checked them, they're connected directly to the negative and positive battery inputs. And I guess that's kind of just a convenient place to solder a capacitor, which they did include a capacitor with this little bag of accessories, by the way. You have some of the little locking connectors and a capacitor and a power connector and battery lead. There is what comes with it, as well as the GPS and a cable for the GPS in this package here. And like I said, obviously I've opened all this stuff up already and looked at it. And there are some mounting foam pieces and the little GPS itself. There's no compass here, I don't think. Actually, there is a 6-pin connector there. Maybe it is, I'm not sure. I don't have any info on this compass. Basically, what I see here is what I know about it. So you know as much as I do. But the lead, if I'm not mistaken, is only a 4-wire lead. So it's just a 4-wire lead that they included with it. So I guess it's intended to use it as a GPS only and not a compass. Which is fine. But yeah, like I said, I'm waiting on some more information about the flight controller from the manufacturer to find out some specifics as far as firmware and targets and configuration and things like that. Again, what I see here is what I know about it, so you know as much as I do at this point. So once we finally able to figure out some more information about that, we'll go ahead and get everything installed and set it up. I do think, initially at least, I'm probably going to use this foam insert on this nose and mount a walk snail camera in here, just a fixed mount. And then I'll probably print a little plastic tray that'll slide in these grooves in here, like a little shelf to slide in those rails. That will hold a transmitter. I don't know if it'll have enough cooling in there, but I guess we'll find out. I'll figure something out. I'll get some walk snail gear mounted in here and fly it. And probably just a basic express LRS receiver, just to keep it simple and quick and easy to set up. And like I said, I'll either set up or do pilot that's already on it if I can't find any more information or get anything else from the manufacturer about it. But at this point, I kind of would like to be able to update it to a newer version of Ardupilot, or possibly even fly INAV on it just to get it in the air a little bit quicker and easier. Which, obviously, I would probably want to go to Ardupilot later. Just because of the style of airplane it is, it's going to make it a pretty decent little portable cruiser style kind of reconnaissance, search and rescue type of thing. And for that, I probably prefer Ardupilot. Especially with that nice case and everything, it'll be quite handy just to kind of throw it in the back of a vehicle and go fly from some remote location if kind of the need ever arose. I think that's kind of its strong point. But anyway, I guess we'll get it in there as soon as we can. But that's just kind of a preliminary look, and just to kind of let you know that it is here and has arrived, and we're going to start working on it as soon as possible. And stay tuned. There's definitely going to be more videos on it once we do get it set up and configured and flying. And once I get answers to some of these questions, I'll fill you all in on that too. Like I said, as far as details about the flight controller, we'll talk about all that stuff more once we get it in the air. But yeah, that's where we're at. So it's pretty neat little looking little package here. And hopefully it flies as good as it looks. I think it's going to be pretty fun. Something different. Change of pace. Neat little cruiser. So thank you for watching this video. It's gone on pretty long for just a quick unboxing preliminary look. But like I said, I kind of wanted to show everything in detail. And give you a heads up of what's to come. So thank you for watching and stay tuned. Keep an eye out for what's to come in the future. Thank you for watching this video. Questions, comments, go below in the comment section as usual. And check the video description for any relevant links that I've mentioned during the video. And I'll see you all in the next one.